Before you can use Node.js in WebStorm, you'll need to go to nodejs.org and download and install it using this giant green button. Then simply create a new project. We'll call this Node Tutorials. Hit OK. And then create a new JavaScript file. We'll call this example. Type in just console log hello world. Then I can right click on this and say run example. Then you can see it opens a run tool window. It runs Node against your example file and then prints out hello world. If you do have multiple Node installations for whatever reason, you can go into your preferences and go to Node.js and NPM, and you can see you can change the Node interpreter between your default install and something like a brew install. Then just make sure if you're going to run it with a different installation, go into your configurations. And the easiest way is just to delete this configuration and then run it again. And you can see it ran against my brew installation this time. And you can always go back and modify your configurations under run, edit configurations, and change around node parameters, app parameters, environment variables, and even add different run configs if you'd like to have different runs for different settings. Typically, I only use one configuration and then I can rerun it as much as I want with a keyboard shortcut, which is either Shift F10 on Windows or Linux or Control R on Mac, or simply just click this run button to rerun your example. Now, because we're using Node, we'll probably want to require some modules. So we'll try typing require. Notice that we get a squiggly line and no autocomplete for it. And that's because we haven't set up Node.js globals to support autocomplete and the references required for Node inside of WebStorm. So we'll just right click and say use JavaScript library, select Node.js globals. And once we try this again, you can see that we get require as possible autocomplete. Now, to use npm to install modules, you can either do that the traditional way through the terminal and just say npm install whatever module you want to install, or you can use the npm tools built into WebStorm under preferences, where you go under Node.js npm, simply click the plus button, and I want to install async, so I'll click on it, hit install package. And I could either specify a version or pass in some options like -g for global. And then I'll notice that my project now has a node modules folder. So to load in async, I'll just put in some quotes and I can actually hit control space for autocomplete. And you'll see async is in the list under node modules, hit enter, and it references it right away. I can even control or command click on it and navigate straight to it to browse what the async file is. So let's go ahead and just type some basic async code to see the editor in action.